Hello fellow pilots, I'm Major Payne and this is another episode of Weekend Gameplay, and today I'm gonna go in F7U. It's tier 10 multirole fighter in American tech tree. It's a plane which I feel it's designed to carry this special lady pilot Mary Lovenheart and her skill, of course, which double damage from the rockets and bombs if we are in a dive, 45 angle dive and close to top speed. Let's go into the battle and I'll show you what this plane is capable of, what his weak points, what his strong points, and possible tactics, of course. So let's straight get into it. So weak point is firepower. We have the worst firepower between the multirole fighters at tier 10. So we shouldn't go head on with any other multirole fighter. We can go head on with light fighters because we have also very good survivability, 700 HP pool. So 700 HP pool is pretty okay, like only BVP German multirole fighter have better. So we can go head on with light fighters when we have HP. They may have slightly better firepower, but thanks to HP we should win the head-on engagement. Now, good point is definitely the speed. We are the fastest multirole fighter at tier 10. We can easily escape from most of the light fighters and we can chase down the heavy fighter. Okay, let's get down to the battle. So enemy have a bomber, Hawker Hunter, LA-15, F6U and J7. We have also bomber, ground attacker and a light fighter also too, tier 9. So we're not gonna go into the command center where most of my team will go. Yeah, on front of me there's command center. Now we're gonna go for the command center which is close to the enemy rest point. See? This way. And so that's a very good tactic for the multirole fighter. We can surprise the enemy by capturing this sector our own way. Like, we just go to the edge of the map, we sneak behind enemy lines, and we suddenly capture the sector, and enemy will be surprised. Like, we'll be thinking, what the hell? What the hell just happened? Who took this sector? And good points are, of course, our beautiful bombs. Which have double damage in dive attack. Okay, and by the way, take a look on the speed and how long I can maintain this speed. So this is very good. We can travel between the sectors extremely fast. So enemy very quickly captured this command center. That's a bad sign because that means the bomber pilot is very good. That could mean that. Okay, I'm gonna drop my bombs first and then I need to take out one air defense. And heavy fighter? Incoming, yeah, F2H. Not gonna chase him, no. So we're gonna dive, drop one bomb on main building, one bomb on 30 points building, and we get back for another attack with bombs. I missed the target a little bit, so I need to finish off the main building with cannons. I try to drop bombs on 30 point target. Woo! Jesus. That's not the way we should do it, okay? That was too risky. Okay, okay. F2H is coming back. Actually, he's gonna be useful. This bot's gonna be useful. If I take him down, we have this sector now. Banshee. Very good. Yeah. This is it, and I have 4,000 personal points for capturing one sector. And enemy is thinking now, what the hell just happened? How did they get there so quickly? See, so I'm thinking to go to garrison now. I just don't want to go too close to the... Anyway, the flight formation will see me anyway. Oh my god, my team very quickly captured this garrison, what else? There's a human player and a bomber, so we may go back to the command center and try to defend it now. So I send the bot on this human player and a bomber. There's our F2H Banshee is going after the human player and a bomber, and he actually gets huge punish. Wow! Okay, he's been shot down by the bomber, and this poor F2H on front of me, I'm gonna kill him second time. But very useful. 40 capture points back to the sector now. There you go. So now I'm thinking the only sector they have is airstrip, and they can have air domination in a moment if I get there. Yeah, almost captured that. Yes. Yeah, very good. So I go after this hunter. So we winning pretty bigly. So I have to be fast because Hunter is more maneuverable and I can't go head on with him. Oh no. Oh, this is so bad. But we're winning, so I did go head on because he was like half of his HP gone, and I was thinking maybe I managed to get him before he is straight up on me. But no. So he has superior firepower. If we go head on with Hunter, we always will get killed. End of story. Maybe I will have a chance to revenge myself in a moment. I just... Oh no, actually I won't. J7W2 is tier 9. Oh, probably shouldn't go head on with him as well. I'm not gonna come back to him, I leave him. So main thing on the multi-role fighter is to go and capture sector. On this one, it's go and capture sector. We not engage into defending sectors in F7U because he don't have this firepower, and we need the firepower to defend sectors. Without the firepower, we would have to need some maneuverability, which we don't have as well. So, okay. So we capture sectors. So I'm dive now for main building. I'm gonna drop two bombs just in case because I don't want to come back to this. And one here and pull up. Ooh. It's definitely not the way we should do it. I could do that better, okay, but I need a little bit more practice. So what left? 80 points now. So two, actually my team is doing a great job and they helped me to capture this so on. And the problem here I have that we have only one consumable slot on engine, and as you see I have this engine cooling, so I have extra 10 seconds of boost, which I love to have, but in case we get engine hit, we have engine damage, then we can't do anything about that, unfortunately. So this is a kind of problem I have with this plane. I want to have more of this boost, even though I have 20 seconds after specialization, but I want that 10 seconds extra. Oh, Banshee again. 60 capture points, great. Poor bot, he doesn't have a lag in this battle. Okay, so one more plane on airstrip and we're gonna capture this small airfield. SU-10 is doing a great job there. Okay, IL-40 maybe, and F6U, IL-40. E211, no, he's dead. So we can try to capture the command center again, and this battle is actually nearly over. We just go to the 600. I try to intercept this poor bot again. Is that gonna be like four time? Well, that's not my fault, but that's not the headhunting of the bot. What a situation. Enemy suddenly have like three sectors. Okay, this one, and then 20 capture points left on this sector, so one more air defense or I'm gonna drop my bombs in a moment. Oh, I hate that. If we get too close to the air defense light fighter, it's really hard to maneuver now. What is that? Oh, F6U, we can go head on with him, actually. We have more HP. Ooh, but not much more, 7 HP left. Okay, so that's a win. Great game, good fun. And I'm actually happy that I had the opportunity to show you this tactic that I'm gonna go for this command center. Like the same with factories, another, or rocket base, that could be, so we can surprise the enemy. With this tactic. Okay, let's get back to the hangar and we go one more. So I show you in the intro how I'm taking over the factory with four bombs. It's pretty easy if you practice that a little bit. It's easy, it's just need to more or less accurately aim those bombs and be in a dive, make sure that this skill is activated. Unfortunately there's a bug which doesn't show you that this skill is activated. At least not always, it's turn on. You didn't see that in this battle. So far I played this machine and I didn't see that to be turned on. So there's a bug which doesn't show you the skill is activated, but it is activated even though you don't see the actually on the screen this information. Okay, so what we have here. Alright, enemy have EF131, two of the specialized bomber, XF90 and J7W2. That's no good, not good. We have SU10, which is great, specialized. We have also tier 9 ground attacker and tier 9 light fighter, TA183. So the plan is I'm gonna go for the garrison, and then from the garrison I will go for the command center. I'm not gonna go for the factory because I assume that ground attacker or SU-10 will be able to quickly take over this factory, so I don't want to interfere like into this and, you know, just waste my bombs over there. So basically I'm gonna hold my bombs, I'm not gonna use them on the garrison here, I'm gonna go after the air defense aircraft, and then I keep my bombs for command center. We have the 120 seconds of reload of these bombs, so it's not long, but it's not so fast that we could waste them anywhere we want. So we need to think where we're gonna use them and when. So that's the main weapon of our plane, basically. So we need to use them on key sectors. Okay, that was quick. And good that we take that first. So enemy took over the command center, and the bomber flight formation always go into the first sector we capture. Okay, my team managed to take over the factory, and I see those two EF131 going together. Interesting. Okay, there's multirole. I'm gonna attack this guy because that's a human player. I'm gonna use the opportunity that he's busy. Someone else. There you go. I know it's sector is not unlocked yet, but I will take this heavy fighter bot in a sector most likely. Could I be fast enough? Okay. Alright. Take out one more air defense, then maybe I drop bombs, we'll see. Oh, so that's the opportunity, nearly dead air defense. Okay. One more. Could actually drop my bombs, that would be quicker now. Okay, he's on fire, he's gone. So I drop my bombs now. What? Okay. Oh, holy crap. It's not good. Not good. And then we have like four sectors now. So bad. That's catastrophe. What the hell just happened? So enemy took over the garrison then factory, and in the meantime my team didn't take anything else. What the hell? What is he doing here? Like, why is this SU-10 here? Like, we took over that sector and he's here. Alright. Nah, that's not good. That's enemy bomber, we send the bot on him. Heavy fighter will go. So I tried to take this garrison, but things look so bad now that it end up now. Just can't believe this goes so quickly. It's another now. 1 HP, oh that's great. Oh that's great. So I'm not gonna even get out from this sector. Probably air defense will get me now. Air defense aircraft. This is so bad. Okay, fair enough. The battle earlier we was playing, I remember that there was LA-15, I think he was in AFK during the battle. Okay, let's start. Who is here on the rest point? What the hell are they thinking? XF-90, of course, who else? Okay, I take out the attacker first and then I'm gonna go after this XF-90 and we'll see. He's too overconfident. What the hell do you think you're doing? You can go to my rest point. No, and not anymore. No, but that's lost. This is lost game. Like 680 points they have. No, we would have to put the air domination, and that would have to be now. Like it's not gonna happen. No. Go away, you. Yeah, you have your revenge. Okay. Well, that's it. I don't think there's even a point to go into that battle. No point. Fair play, like, they play very well. XF-90 was doing basically whatever he was like to do. Nobody stopped this guy. Well, except probably I once. I kill him. That's not good enough. His air domination in the early stage of the battle was just very quick. Okay, good game, enemy team. Nice results. Okay, so we're gonna go another battle. I was thinking that I'm gonna play two, but if we get been wrecked so quickly in this one, so we go another one. Unexpected. Yeah. That's unfortunate. There was a problem with I don't want to complain on my team, but literally after we take over the garrison and factory, and then I take over this command center and like nothing else. like one sector airbase. What the hell, Mr. Man? What the fuck? Like just one sector and it's airbase in the middle. So he didn't even go to the factory, apparently. So that's the ground attacker was taking over the factory. Great, great. Well, not, yeah, well, I mean, I can't wrap my head around this, so. Okay, this guy, okay, he stand out, but never mind. Let's go another one, and maybe we will have a chance to show something better than this. I have to say that I was making a mistake as well on this command center. I could take that quicker if I would use my bombs. I don't know why I was saving those bombs, probably for another battle. That makes no sense, like. Don't do that. Like if you are in a key sector, drop those bombs, take it as quick as possible. Maybe we wouldn't have this air domination. And as you know, in air domination, we're just losing so many points. Like every second we lose 3 points. And normally that sector would give you 3 points every 5 seconds. So that's a big difference. And of course, a factory reload of 80 points is speed up as well. Okay, oh, new map. Good, same map. And same enemy flight. That's great or not, let me think. They have F7U, which is not specialized, so I feel confident that I can outmaneuver him. I have better plane, basically. XF-90 is a plane which is not gonna be counter. I mean, I can counter him if I do it right. We have F131, not specialized, and they have specialized. That's okay. That's not such a big difference between them. specialized or not, they still can bomb targets more or less the same way. Obviously specialized is a little bit better. Okay, so what's the plan? So it's only four garrisons, no key sectors here, and this airfield. So there is no light fighters in the enemy team that can literally stop me on that airfield. So I'm gonna go there, I drop the one bomb on this air defense, I grab another bomb on 20 points air defense and two on main building, and I fight for this airfield, airbase. Yeah, so it's important to get down this XF-90 at least once, so I'm not gonna be feel so confident. Good, very good. Mm-hmm. Think that you can fly around and kill all my team? Not this time. Okay, nice. So I want to keep this airbase. This is very important for my team because this is in the middle of the map, so my team will start in there. But I'm not gonna just camp over there only, so I try to capture some other sectors, but I keep this airbase on my mind, like I keep it in the back of my head just to get there. I waste my time here already, that's not good. Okay. Let's try to capture this garrison. We defend this airbase first. This is easy target. We restore some capture points. XF-90 probably is in the way here already. Definitely will come back to the airbase in my opinion. It's not only about the repair unit here, it's more like you can resp in the center of the map and you have very short distance to all those garrisons. And there is XF-90, of course he's coming. Good. Let's go after him. Okay. Alright, you know what? I'm gonna leave him. I'm gonna leave him. I got back to the airbase. And he's wasting his time. I send a bot on him. And he can have fun with bot. And I keep defending my sector. That's the key sector in this map. I try to recapture that quickly. What are you doing here? It, now it's unlocked, sector is unlocked. I see on minimap two bombers just start again. Oh, fuck's sake, with you. F7U. So, my team. Yeah, now we have four sectors around, that's good, but we're losing them quickly, I see. I need to get back to the middle of me. I have to recapture this. This is a key sector here. If I keep this airfield, my team have a better chance to win this. Let's get focus. Oh, fuck's sake. No, one sector. They have four sectors. That's no good. Okay, I'm gonna go there. There's XF90 also over there. That's great. I need to start using my bombs as well. Okay, so two life air defense. As I mentioned, they're not easy to take down when you get close to them. Too close is no good. Right, fuck it, I dropped the bombs on the ground targets. I'm not gonna be turning with the Spitfire, for fuck's sake. Yes, one more 30 and I have two bombs. Excellent. So this XF90 is above me, and if I capture that, then he wastes his time. And this F7U is behind me. Oh, go away, go away. Alright, fine, fair enough. But I have a sector. I've been killed after I take over sector. This is success. And his Squaline is coming. As you probably know, 5 minutes before the end of the battle, we have Squaline. Such a temptation to change the plane for Heavy Fighter and give them like a slap. But no, I'm gonna stay on F7U, because this is F7U video. Okay, so I try to hunt them down. I have 20 seconds, a little bit over. So, need to kill... We're actually losing. Are we gonna kill planes, or are we gonna put air domination, or more sectors? 9 more sec... 8 seconds. No, I'm not gonna turn in with him. Fuck's sake. He's gonna get killed by my air defense, for Christ's sake here. Like what, 20? Not even 20 HP. Yeah, very good. Chasing enemy with points. Oh, there is my friend. Would be nice. I have no boost. That's not a good idea now to go after him. No. Fuck that. No. LA-15. I can't lose the airfield. I need to have this airfield. Way above my limits. Okay, there's a bomber. Oh, that would be nice to get him. How's the things looking now? If I keep the airfield, airbase, that would be great. Come on, can't lose that one. Alright, yes. No, that wasn't in sector, for fuck's sake. But, okay, but there's no one in airbase at the moment. Yes, yes. Okay, so, alright, the two guys left, that's it. Brilliant. Brilliant. That was a bit stupid. On my part, of course. Okay, that's the last plane. Okay, we win. Oof, I can relax. Don't need my engine now. So I had my revenge on this enemy flight, which I lost battle before. 19,000 personal points, that's nice. Like for this machine, it's pretty good. Okay. Alright, I was actually a bit focused on the battle. But that's payoff, and we win that, that's great. But I understand that there was no like factories, which I would love to show you how I'm capturing key sectors like factory, and thanks to this I'm winning the battle, because this plane is all about capturing sectors. It's not about dogfights, it's not about defending sectors. We have no firepower, we have no maneuverability for that, but I'm happy that this game plays out like that, because that shows you that in this particular situation where there is no light fighters which can easily counter me in the middle, we should go and take this fight in the middle. Because for this map with four garrison and airbase in the middle, airbase is very important, it's most important sector basically. So I spend a little bit time on defending this. I kill a lot of bots, which helped me to restore the capture points of the sector. I have to recapture that once, but and the mainly what makes me happy here is that I show you that this plane can chase down the heavy fighter, even heavy fighter like XF90, yes. So it's amazing machine in my opinion, very good plane, but for very experienced pilots, it's not for beginners, absolutely not, because it's very difficult. You need to have very good situational awareness, you need to know where to drop those bombs, how to drop those bombs. A lot of knowledge is required for this machine to be very effective, but it's actually very good. I like it, and I'm definitely gonna fly it more than this occasion. I specialize it, and after specialization it's actually marvelous. I didn't actually expect that he's gonna be that fast. It was fast before specialization, but now I'm just amazed. Okay guys, thank you very much for watching. That will be it in this video. I hope you find it useful. I hope you're gonna implement some of my ideas and tactics into your gameplay, and that's gonna improve your skills and results. If you like it, please leave a like, subscribe for future content, and guys, thank you very much for watching again, and see you in the next one, and happy Easter to you.